The first two semesters are pretty hectic in that you have four courses to work with, and each of them has a higher number of credits, blah, blah, blah. So there's lots of assignments, the exams come at different times, and then you have to juggle all of that. Plus, it depends on the kind of course you take. So if you take courses that you're not too familiar with, then you have to sit and study for it while the lectures are not going on. I used my master's degree, to be completely honest, as like a path to changing the career that I was in back then. So when I was at BJTI, I did my bachelor's in electrical engineering. BJTI doesn't have anything called electrical and electronics. It's purely electrical. And I just like took a leap of faith and I decided, okay, this course at Georgia Tech offering ECE has a lot of scope in those areas. And they were kind enough to give me an admit. So why not just go for it? Operating systems and computer architecture were the two basic courses, I would say, or basic subjects that I just went and studied more and more in depth through my master's. With all of the machine learning and deep learning happening, you need a lot of hardware that can do all the kind of computations that you require them to do. And when it comes to all of that, there's a good amount of research going on in the field of computer architecture to create better graphic processing units, because those are the ones that do all of this computation. Along with that, on the electrical side, I would say 5G is also picking up.